Okay, we're back here at the BST podcast at El Paso County Raceway. We got Jeff Seasoltz here, another one of our ASCS sprint car racers. Jeff, tell us what's going on.
Oh, not much. Just getting ready for the season. It's going to be a very competitive season, I'm thinking, this year.
We've been talking all morning, actually, and it seems like we're talking a lot about the sprint car stuff, but there's actually more sprint car drivers here than any, so that's one of the reasons. But it's also kind of the new division, new kid on the block, if you will, and also one of our elite divisions. Ironically, we call it the Elite Series for a reason.
Right.
But you came from Modifieds, correct?
That's correct. I ran Modifieds before moving here to Colorado. I'm originally from California, ran them out there for about 3 or 4 years, moved out here and struggled with them for about 3 years. And when this whole division came up, and I never before even thought of being in a sprint car. After this division and sitting down with Mike Hathaway talking about it, it seemed like it would be a better fit for me.
You know, and you did struggle and modified a little bit, but you started getting that going. I believe these tracks are probably a little smaller and tighter than what you're maybe used to.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I ran a Paris Auto Speedway, which is a real big half-mile, real fast track, and coming to these small, tight corner ones is...
Yeah, I think that was... So maybe your hang-up might not have been the division per the difference in track sizes is what
right.
I was thinking. Because I remember talking to you when you first got here, and I was like, man, you gotta slow that thing down. Got to get it to rotate.
Right.
Rotation is big out here.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, it doesn't matter what division you're in. So I think the practice that you've had and the experience you've had on the track is helping you. But obviously the sprint cars are fitting you. You're doing very well there. Didn't you almost win one or get real close?
Well, I actually did have 2 second place finishes. One of them actually counted. The other one I actually got DQ'd on.
Oh, had a tire issue.
Yeah, a little tire issue. That was my fault. But no,
and
it did really
in all fairness, that tire you had didn't have anything
to do with performance.
It was just an old tire that you had that you thought was legal that wasn't legal.
Exactly.
At the end of the day, so. It's not like you had a super soft
no,
tire.
No. It's just one that I grabbed and put it on and didn't realize. And
Yeah. We've all done dumb things like that.
Believe me, I've learned to look at those now.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
But
I'm glad you're running it. Tell us your pick. We've been talking to people once again all day about this, and everybody's saying 15 to 20 cars on day one. What's your pick? How many cars do you think?
Actually, I think we're going to push the 20. I think we're going to be 20 to maybe 22.
Yeah. The last interview we had, I was telling them that I think for the first time in probably 20 years, we're going to have 20-plus sprint cars in Colorado.
Yes, exactly. And, I mean, that's been talking about it and stuff. And, you know, you're really going to have to up your game. I mean, you're not just going to come out now with, if we start getting 20-plus cars, you know, just thinking you're going to make the A main. You got, you know, we might start getting into that B main, you know, territory. And
so I'll give you a little heads up. You know, there's one guy you don't have to worry about weekly, and that's Zach Taylor that we just interviewed. You know, he let the cat out of the bag that he's only going to be able to run a few of these, and he's going to run the midgets. He's going out of town. So you guys are going to luck out there. You don't have to contend with him week in, week out.
Well, that's big for the points. But on the nightly issue, you know, he's still a competitor.
Oh, yeah. No, when he's here, you know, he's going to be up front.
Yeah. So. This class is really, I mean, it's come a long way. I mean, we've got, you know, the ASCS coming on, the Boot Barn Hall sponsorship. I mean, all that stuff is just really awesome. I mean, for anybody that's looking to get into this, it's time to get off the porch and get in a car.
Get out there with the big dogs.
Yes, I mean,
How about that point fund? $7,500 now.
Just think about that. I mean, who else is offering point fund like that?
We were talking about that as well. You know, old school racing, there was always point funds, kept people in the mix, kept people wanting to come back.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to be big. So I think that's something that we're going to have to kind of carry on to other divisions if we can.
Yeah.
Heck, even our SUV,
side-by-sides.
Yep. They've got a point fund for their deal. So I was like, well, that's pretty cool.
You know, when you talk about it, points, I mean, I was last year's Rookie of the Year, first time in a sprint car. You know, I had my issues. I didn't make like 3 or 4 races, but I still ended up 3rd in points. Now, if I had actually, I calculated, if I had shown up to those other races, I could have probably gave Zach a run for the money. I would have been right there number-wise.
Yep.
No. So it's, you know, there's if you come out and be competitive, you know, that's the thing. Everybody's got a chance.
Exactly, exactly. All right, well, I want to thank you for coming by. I don't know if your car's ready. If it's not, get it ready.
It's we got. If we were racing today, it would be here.
You could do it? Okay, because we got hot laps April 4th, I believe, which is, what, 2 weeks away?
Two weeks away, of course, the first race
is the 25th, so it won't be long.
I'm looking forward to both practices.
It'll be on like Donkey Kong.
Yep.
Take care.
Take care, man.
Thank you.